Every time you connect it with the board, it will you need to choose the port correctly. Otherwise, it will not. It will generate an error. Okay. So as I have already started, so you can see on the video, it is already blinking. That Arduino, that LED is already blinking for 300 milliseconds. Okay. So this is one experiment that I wanted to show. So let's go to the next one, where I'll show you how to sense the temperature in. I'll show you the code as well. So here is the particular code. So let me show you the pin number and the schematic first. So yeah, here it is. So basically, this is the program on the sensor KY028. It's a digital temperature sensor module. So you get the specification in the documentation that I have provided in the today's folder with your Google Google Gmail account. It is already shared with you. So basically, if you see, this is the schematic as well as the pin diagram. So this A0, all this KY sensor name, I mean pin name, is already mentioned on the particular sensor. It's written in a very small small letter, so you need to look at it carefully. So the A0 of sensor is connected with the A0 of the this particular device, Arduino Uno, and same applies to ground. So G is connected with the GND, ground of the our Uno board, and the power the power supply, the 5-volt power supply, is provided from the connected to the power supply of the board, as well as the output, the digital output we are taking on the pin number 2. Okay, it is coming on the on your screen, and also keeping it very close so you can have a look on it. Okay, so let's go to the code. I have already shared the code with you. Also, here is the code, and the output is also given, but I am demonstrating it with you on the IDE. Yeah, here it is. So basically, this code I've already burned. Again, if I need to run it, I need to connect this thing on my. So see, it is going now. The sensor is going now. So what I need to do, I just need to again select the port correctly. So it is not correctly selected. So I need to click it. So now the port is selected. So I need to just click this button, upload. So the port will be uploaded on my Arduino board, and the eventually it will start reading the sensor values. So now it is burning. So here you can see the screen is showing you the digital values on the screen. The program, once I ran it, it is showing on the serial monitor output. Okay. So this is the case of the KY028 sensor.
I think the audio, there is some issue with the audio. Am I audible, please? Yeah. Please, I'll just try to brief you about this.
You are audible, yes, sir.
So I'll just try to brief you what is exactly happened here is. Just 2 minutes. So here, Arduino board is connected with a temperature sensor. So KY028, the digital sensor he has connected. And of course, he is using the pins. So please, can you open the code once?
Open the code.
Share those code screen. So the output is coming here, the temperature of this particular room. Full screen. No, ID. Arduino ID. Let me explain a small the code what he has written here. So it's the same whatever you have used in the simulator, the similar process here. So he is using the pin number 2, digital pin number 2, and the analog pin number A0, and he is using another two values to collect those corresponding digital values once it has been converted. Whereas the serial baud rate he is using is 115200, which is a different than the standard baud rates. So he has set up from this serial so that he can communicate from the digital sensor to this particular Arduino board. That's what your communication, the data set sensor readings have been collected here. So in the loop, he has initialized that variable digital value is equal to digital read from that digital pin number of 2 from the temperature sensor. Then when it is high, if it's not high, you are going to turn on the LED. So both the things, LED turn on and off, along with that, when the temperature is high, he has mentioned that particular logic. So this is how you are going to run. That's what he was trying to explain to you in this. And he has just given a small demo on how to connect it. I think connection he has shown it. So connection he has already shown, it seems. So let me proceed to the next one. Yeah, so he'll take over it now. Yes.
Yeah, am I audible now? Okay, so on the next experiment, we are using the temperature sensor module of KY013. In this case, there are the pin values I will share on the screen. This is the KY013 analog temperature sensor module. So previously we are using KY028, that was digital. This one is analog. So we need to do some mathematical calculation in order to get the digital value out of this analog sensor. So here is the precision and the temperature measurement range and everything is given in the documentation. You will follow it. And this is provided the pin values and the how it should be connected on the with the Arduino. So I have already connected with the A5 the output, the ground, and the power supply on the Arduino board. And as you can see, this sensor KY103 is connected with the Arduino using this schematic. Okay, it is already shared the schematic on your screen is coming. So if we can see the code now for KY013. Okay, so let me explain this. First of all, this particular thermistor pin, I have set it as A5. You can also set it according to your own wish, out of A0 to A5, anyone you can choose, anyone for analog pin. Now, this in the case of this thermistor pin, there is a mathematical calculation. So I would like to share you that particular mathematical calculation from where I referred and made the code. So, here it is, basically Steinhardt Hardt equation of TMK thermistor. Using these formulas, we just tried to formulate the this entire scenario on the program. So as you can see in the code, we have just changes the values in the case of ABC on the particular formula of Steinhardt equation. We have taken C1, C2, and C3. And we have taken these values as a standard value in Indian Indian conditions. So after that, in this setup pin, one thing I'd like to mention, which I forgot in the previous two experiments, every time you burn the code, you choose a proper baud rate. So here for the Arduino, we have selected 115200. And when you will be seeing the output on the serial monitor, you also need to change the baud rate so that it should come properly on the screen. So the next thing is void loop. In the void loop, what we are doing the calculation from the thermistor pin. We are taking the value and we are using the Steinhardt-Hardt equation to basically calculate it. And basically the output is coming in Kelvin. And using the C by 5 equals to F minus 32 by 9, that centigrade to Fahrenheit calculation, we also calculate the Fahrenheit value. So this one is centigrade and this one is Fahrenheit value we have calculated. So once I connect this with my this particular Arduino board with my laptop, now I'll select the proper board and see, you can see the temperature is coming on your screen as Fahrenheit as well as centigrade format. Okay, so these are the three experiments with the Arduino board that I wanted to show you. Thank you so much for your patience. Now Nagendra Kumar sir will take over.
The setup which you are seeing on the now on the table is basically connecting an Arduino board to a Raspberry Pi using USB. So this is a good combination for our IoT systems. Basically you are connecting your USB serial to your Raspberry Pi through your USB port of Raspberry Pi. So the combination means you connect your sensors to the Arduino board and collect the data from the Arduino board, and you can pass on to your Raspberry Pi using your I2C or SPI peripheral devices and start communicating with them. It means you are collecting the data and you are processing the data on the Raspberry Pi rather than just on the Arduino board. The purpose of this is when you collect a huge quantity of data and to have the correlation among the sensor values and with the other set of values. So the combination of those set of values can be easily correlated and can be processed on the Raspberry Pi rather than on the Arduino board. So whenever you want to interact with the outside world, means the hardware components, you can connect through your Arduino board. Whereas if you want to process it and do some kind of make some decisions, you can do it with your Raspberry Pi. So the changes here, nothing as such. The only thing is on the Raspberry Pi, you need to install the library of Arduino. Arduino installation on the Raspberry Pi. Once you install the Arduino library on the Raspberry Pi, it starts collecting the data from your system to set the values. So these are the practicals which we like to share. Of course, there is a disturbance here in some of our things. It is internet issues are there. Yes, any other doubts, please. And of course, in the for today's practice, this is what we like to share. So please practice on the simulators first, then do practice on the real systems, then I hope the beginners will definitely gain it. Of course, the examples are very little, only what the few things we have given. Nevertheless, it will be a starting point to explore more in a more better way. Do you know library on the Raspberry Pi? That's the problem. Tomorrow we'll see that one. I'll definitely show you tomorrow because there's a problem over here and we'll just postpone it to the tomorrow session, please. Yeah. And one thing, yesterday somebody is asking about the OpenCV. Already, let me share the OpenCV document to you all. So just hold on. Yesterday's demo, we have seen an OpenCV installation. So